Dragon uniforms with black numbers, black trim, and the Golden Hurricane in their home white uniforms with royal blue trim. J.R. Rallo, your keys to the game.
Just real quickly, Tom, I mean, I can tell on the court right now, Tulsa's loose. They're jumping around. So more of the same. Tulsa's playing at a very high level right now. We got to keep it up. That's where your senior leadership comes to maintain that level of play. Secondly, not to sound redundant, but we've got to rebound, rebound, rebound. Coach said it. I've said it. Ohio's lineup is 6'8", 6'9", 6'9", 6'10". And so we have our work cut out for. They out-rebounded Florida Gulf Coast by 14 early in the year. So finally, have fun. Continue to stay loose. Play like a championship team.
Campbell to tip against Wright, and we're ready for Golden Hurricane basketball. Tulsa against Ohio. The officials today, Brian Kersey, Ray Steins, and Matt Oblas. And Ohio wins the tip, and Simmons will control for the Bobcats. Dribbles to the left wing, stops, brings it to the top of the key to Kaminsky. Picks up his dribble, throws it left side for Simmons, guarded by Woodard. Right side for Kaminsky. Right corner it goes for Campbell. Campbell brings it back out, shot clock down to 10. It's Simmons with the left hand, stops, gives it to Campbell, long three, goes down for Antonio Campbell.
Looks like we came out in a man-to-man there. They really worked it around for a night.
Tulsa, Shaq coming off a terrific game against Wichita State. Flips it to Ray, now Woodard. Back to Harrison at the top of the key. Dribbles to the right elbow, picks up his dribble, gives it to Smith. Smith inside for Wright, spin move on Campbell, into the lane, one-hander, no good. Campbell rips down the rebound for Ohio. Here come the Bobcats the other way with Simmons. Right-handed dribble, dribbles to the top of the key. And on him is Ray. Now they flip it to the free throw line. Now back left side for Simmons, who hits a three on the feed from Kyrie Harley, and it's 6-0 Ohio.
Ohio definitely came ready to play.
And faced early with a 6-0 deficit is Harrison and Tulsa to Ray at the top of the key. Now back to Harrison. Harrison guarded there by Seti. Treg Seti, a 6'9 forward. This is a long, athletic Ohio team. Three ball is missed by Woodard, and the rebound comes down, and a foul is called against Ohio.
It was a great shot there, and a great rebound by Smith to go get that ball and keep possession.
So it'll stay with Tulsa, with 30 on the shot clock and 18:24 on the game clock, and a 6-0 lead for Ohio University. Harrison with the inbound pass for the Hurricane. To Ray, back to Harrison on right wing. He's guarded by Seti. He goes around him. He throws one inside to Wright, who throws it down. He was fouled. And DeAndre Wright gets on the board for Tulsa.
That's just great vision by Shaquille. He dribbled to the opposite side and saw DeAndre clear near the basket, and a great pinpoint pass.
Right to the free throw line. A 6-2 Ohio lead, 18:16 on the clock. Wright with three dribbles, lets the free throw fly, and he hits it. So the three-point play converted by DeAndre Wright, and it's 6-3 Ohio.
Looks like we're staying in the man-to-man.
Jerron Simmons, left-handed dribble to left wing, guarded there by Ray. He gets it back from Kaminsky, still on left wing. Simmons looks inside, doesn't find anyone. Kaminsky has it, Smith on him at the top. Dribbles to the free throw line, leaves it for Simmons, who traveled. Turnover back to Tulsa.
Tulsa seems to be settling down a little bit defensively. They're very, very tight.
Ohio came out, knocked down two quick threes to take a 6-0 lead. It's 6-3, 2 minutes gone in the Virgin Islands. Glad you're with us. Harrison on left wing for the Golden Hurricane. Dribbles around Seti, now to the left baseline. Kicks it out for Ray, right wing for Woodard. Woodard with the left-handed dribble to the right elbow to Smith. Now left side for Harrison. Bounces it inside to Wright. Double team, lost it, gets it back, puts it on the deck. Wright goes into the lane, leaves it for Smith. It went off an Ohio player. They're going to call a foul, though, first on Campbell.
What a great job by DeAndre to face up and see what the defense gave him and take it. A great pass to Smith.
So Tulsa will get the ball underneath the basket. Harrison with the inbound, looks for the open man, looks at a cutting Ray, now looks, throws to the back to Smith. Now the top of the key, three on the way, missed short by Woodard. Back to Simmons across the timeline for Ohio. 6-3 Bobcat lead over Tulsa nearly 3 minutes into the game. Simmons with the high dribble. Ray guarding him. Tries to come off a screen, puts a three and knocks it in. Simmons with a three. That's three long distance shots by Ohio, and it's 9-3. Smith, top of the key for Tulsa. Left side for Harrison, dribbles to the free throw line, runs into Seti, knocked down, no call. Smith pulls up from the left elbow, and it rattles in for Rashad Smith.
That's a big time move right there, behind the back dribble into his jump shot.
9-5, the Ohio lead, 16:40 on the clock. Simmons brings it left side, now to Kaminsky at the top. Guarded there by Smith, gets those long arms right in his face. Seti takes it from Kaminsky, now gets it to Simmons. They dump it inside to Campbell, draws a double team, floats one up and over right for the basket. It's 11-5 Ohio.
Ohio is on fire right now.
Harrison with it on the left side of the floor for Tulsa. Comes off a screen from Smith, slashes in, lays it up and in. Shaq Harrison with the basket. Harrison with a strong move to the bucket. That's where he's so effective and has been for some time. Great slasher and a much improved player. Simmons with it for Ohio. Now to Campbell. He's made one three, thought about another at the top and does not. Leaves it for Simmons, drives in. Foul called on the floor against Tulsa. 15:50 on the clock. The score, Ohio 11, Tulsa 7. This is Golden Hurricane basketball from Learfield Sports.
Okay. We're going to have to extend the defense a little.
Rated E10 for ages 10 and up.
Experience your Virgin Islands nice. Book one of our packages today.
Back in the Virgin Islands, Ohio leads Tulsa 11-7. Let's pause 10 seconds for station identification. You're listening to TU Basketball from Learfield Sports. Ohio with the four-point lead and the basketball. Harley with it for the Bobcats. Throws right side for Simmons. Simmons throws to the right corner to Seti, gets it back. Now to Harley on left wing. Pulls up at the top of the key, leaves it for Seti on left wing. Shot clock down to 7. Kaminsky takes a 3 and a foul is called. He'll get 3 free throws as they whistle the foul on Woodard.
That was a ghost call right there. I'm not sure he even made contact, but Tulsa's going to have to get out on the jump shooter because Ohio has not missed a shot yet.
Ohio on fire early, and for Kaminsky, he's really struggled from the outside early on this season, but a very good three-point shooter, and his first free throw goes down, so he's going to try to get 3 points the hard way. Tulsa fans, when it comes to Rocky Mountain Cold Coors Light, 21 means 21. With great beer comes great responsibility. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. Next one made by Kaminsky. He'll get one more. Checking into the game for Tulsa is Sterling Taplin. And Woodard will take a seat after committing the foul. as Kaminsky made all three free throws.
They are still perfect.
So Tulsa with it. Brown is in the game for the Hurricane. So is Burt. And slashing to the hole and getting it to Brown and back out for Curtis. Markel Curtis hits the shot from the right wing, a three-pointer to cut it to 14-10.
Great recognition by Brown down low. He fumbled it, but saw Curtis spotting up and hitting.
Simmons brings it up the floor for Ohio. Four-point lead for the Bobcats, 14:50 to go first half. Simmons to Harley, and a foul is called inside. It's going to go against Swanigan, pushing and shoving with the big man for Ohio, Mon Premier.
They are calling it extremely tight.
That they are. Swanigan has a chat with the official, and the ball will go to the baseline for the inbounds play. Simmons looking for an open man. Laster has him. Now to Kaminsky. Thought about a three. Instead goes in the lane. Puts up a wild shot. No. It's out of bounds. Off Ohio. Mom Premier, the last to touch it. Tulsa basketball.
Well, it's a good thing they finally missed a shot. Now we can get going.
Whistle and a stoppage here. They'll talk things over with the Ohio sideline. They believe that Tulsa touched it last. Yeah. That was not the call. They'll give it to Tulsa. Underneath the basket.
Coach Saul is not happy over there.
He's not at all. He is red-faced, and that's not a sunburn. Burt inbound to Taplin. Taplin's been a good freshman guard for this Tulsa team already. Curtis makes a strong move underneath the basket. Missed the layup. Ball goes out of bounds off Ohio. Mont Premier again, the last to touch it. And boy, they're still having a conversation with the Ohio coach and the official. Now a tap on the shoulder, and it seems like that has come to an end. But they are really letting the officials have it on that side. Inbound pass to Curtis, pulls up, shot is short, rebounded by Simmons, and here comes Ohio. Dribbling with his head up is Simmons on the right side of the floor. Dribbles between his legs, guarded by Curtis, pulls up just inside three and hits the shot. Simmons with another basket, and it's 16-10. Simmons has 8 points.
Well, he's their leading scorer, and I can see why. He can fill it up.
Burt goes left side for Taplin. Taplin back to Burt. Burt left side of the floor, left-handed shot missed long. Rebound taken by Kaminsky. Ohio with a 16-10 lead and the ball. Simmons drives into the lane, goes in on two members of the Tulsa team, 20-10. And now a wholesale change. Frank Haith putting five players into the game. He wants a change, and he wants it now. Burt with it at the left elbow, drives in, and a foul is called as Burt was slashing in for Tulsa. 13:30 to go, 18-10 Ohio.
Burt saw that the defender was coming out, made a nice little fake, and took it to the basket. Showed a little side of his game right there that we haven't seen much from.
So Curtis, Taplin, Brown, Swanigan, and Burt come out of the game. And back in, the starting lineup of Harrison, Ray, Smith, Wright, and Woodard.
Those guys did a nice job, but we got to find a way to stop Ohio.
Inbound pass from Harrison goes to Ray, now to Woodard. Just to the right of the top of the key. Goes left side for Smith. Floats one inside to Wright. Makes a move on Campbell. Now fires across the lane to Woodard. In the lane, he's fouled as he goes up for the shot. Woodard getting to the free throw line. Tulsa down by eight.
That's a great recognition of the offense and knowledge of the offense there by DeAndre. He knew that Woodard was going to be coming from the corner. Almost made a blind pass there.
TU basketball brought to you by Pepsi, all for Hurricane. Free throw missed by Woodard. 18-10 is the Ohio lead, 13-17 first half. Checking into the game, Simmons is going to take a seat. And Ohio brings in Gavin Block, a 6'6 freshman guard. They're a big team, but very young. Block has been a good addition for them as Woodard misses the free throw. Whistle underneath, it's going to go to Ohio.
Woodard is just a little bit off right now. He still hasn't made a shot. Just needs to knock one down and he'll be fine.
This is Jordan Dardis bringing it up the floor. Another freshman guard. Dardis and Block have been good additions to this Ohio team. Seti misses an open three on the left side on the feed from Dardis, and back the other way goes to Tulsa. On right wing, it's Harrison. Dribbles to the left elbow, leaves it for Smith. Jab step, now brings it right side of the floor for Wright. Wright cut off at the baseline by Campbell. Now to Smith, back to Harrison. They reverse it to Ray. Ray goes in for a layup, missed it short. Rebound Seti. Ohio back the other way with Dardis. He throws to Seti. Now left side it goes for Block. Cross-court pass. Driving baseline and stepping out of bounds was Laster, and Ohio turns it over again.
Great job by Woodard there to cut off the baseline, and the Ohio guy used his arm to push off.
They're going to call that foul on Laster, his second. 16 fouls on Ohio, 3 on Tulsa. Harrison brings it up the floor for Tulsa. Left side it goes for Woodard, now right side Smith. Smith drives into the lane. Shovel pass to Harrison, up and in for the layup. Shaq Harrison with the basket. He has 4 points, and Tulsa cuts it to 18-12.
Rashad Smith continues his passing excellence.
That breaks an 0-for-4 drought by Tulsa from the floor. Seti driving right side, spin move, no. Harrison grabs the rebound for Tulsa, and here they come. For Smith, left side, Woodard for three, missed it short. Smith grabs the rebound, goes out of bounds, and a foul is called against Ohio.
Boy, Smith is just battling down there, doing a great job.
Rashad Smith all over the place as he got off to a great start in that Wichita State game, and he's trying to get some energy going now for Tulsa. 11:46 to go, first half. Ohio leading Tulsa 18-12 at the Paradise Jam. This is Golden Hurricane Basketball from Learfield Sports.
Rated E10 for ages 10 and up.
I'm Tom Ackerman. Tulsa down 18-12 to Ohio. 11:46 to go, first half at the Paradise Jam at the University of the Virgin Islands. And if Tulsa is going to win this game, they'll have to flip the switch and find some offense, because it's been all Ohio from that standpoint.
You know, I don't think Ohio can continue to shoot at that pace. So, you know, Tulsa just needs to settle down, keep doing what they're doing, work the extra pass, work their offense. They're getting shots. We just need Woodard to get going here.
Rashad Smith at the free throw line. Fouled before the break. Free throw is up and short. A flat free throw arc from Smith, and Ohio with the rebound. Simmons brings it up the left side of the floor. He's the leading scorer in this game with 10 points. Perfect from the floor. 2-for-2 from three. 4-for-4 overall. Throws one out of bounds, however, and it goes back to Tulsa.
Still in the man-to-man. Looks like we're tightening the reins just a little bit on him, on Simmons.
Harrison will bring it up the floor for the Golden Hurricane. Down by 6 with 11.5 to go, first half. Harrison comes off a screen from Smith. Looks left side for Woodard. Has him. Bounce pass gets to Woodard and fouled as he was entering the lane.
Boy, they really, the referees are really calling it tight this year. It's one of the big initiatives, is to clean up the game and, you know, speed it up a little bit. But they're calling it tight.
Well, Tulsa's already in the bonus. That is team foul number 8 on Ohio with 11:20 to go in the first half.
That's unreal.
Tulsa with 3 team fouls. Woodard with the left-handed shot. That one goes down. He'll get another.
There we go. That's what we needed right there.
Gets a high five from Wright. Always talking in there, these seniors. Such great communicators. Been together for so long. Woodard knocks down another. It's 18-14.
Now we see a little extended pressure here by the Hurricane.
Simmons guarded by Curtis. Follows him up the floor. Follows him to the left side of the floor. Simmons now dribbles to the top of the key. Leaves it for Kaminsky left side. 3 on the way. Good. Hit it right in the face of Rashad Smith. Kaminsky hits the 3, and it's 21-14. Harrison to the top of the key to the right side of the floor, guarded by Seti. Brings it left side for Smith. Now to Woodard. Cross-court pass to Curtis. Handoff goes for Harrison. Dribbles just inside the top of the key. Contact on the shot. No call. Here's Simmons back the other way for Ohio. Leaves it inside for Campbell. His shot goes down. And he's fouled. He'll go to the free throw line.
Boy, Ohio really came to play. This Simmons guy is their energizer. I mean, he gets it done. And he's exceptional so far today.
He has been terrific. They have had some issues in the past not having a natural point guard at Ohio. But Jerron Simmons has been just what they needed. The redshirt sophomore, 6'1 guard, has been terrific. And Campbell misses the free throw. A battle for it inside, but Smith comes up with it. Now to Harrison. It's 23-14 Ohio with 10.5 to go first half in the Virgin Islands. Harrison. At the top of the key, dribbles left side, now flips one up off the backboard. No, but dunked home with a call goaltend. They're going to wave it off. An offensive goaltend on Wright. They say it was in the cylinder as he threw it down with force, but they'll wave off the basket.
That's too bad, but it was still a tremendous athletic play by DeAndre Wright. Hopefully to get this Hurricane jump started.
Simmons with the left-handed dribble up the left side of the floor. He's a 6'1 guard, and he is strong. He looks like a defensive back as he dribbles to the left wing and hits a 3. No. Rebound, Smith. He pulled up for 3, and Smith snared the rebound, and now it's Harrison dribbling out of trouble around Seti, around Campbell. Puts one up, no. Rebound taken by Simmons. All alone on the other end is Seti, and he is knocked out of bounds hard by Wright. Fouled as he slammed into the base of the basket.
You know, they are so long, we're trying to penetrate, and they're changing it. So we're going to have to make the extra pass once the defense commits. Good foul by DeAndre. You don't want to give up a dunk right there.
So Seti will go to the free throw line as Wright is whistled for his second foul. So Swanigan is going to check into the game for him. As Seti dribbles 3 times, bends his knees. Splashes the free throw. It's a 10-point Ohio lead, 24-14. Tulsa 0 for its last 4 from the floor and 1 for its last 9, shooting 31%. Seti gets the roll on the second free throw. It's 25-14.
We got to stop the bleeding here pretty quick. I mean, you cannot let them get up much more than they are right now.
Shaq Harrison brings it across the timeline. Throws left side for Swanigan. Handoff goes to Burt. Burt slashes into the lane, puts up a wild left shot, no good with his left hand. Rebound Swanigan, can't get the roll. They wave off the shot. They call a foul on the floor against the Ohio guard. Block. Block gets his first foul. Swanigan at the free throw line.
There's a reason they have 9 fouls. They obviously came out here to set the tone physically, and they're playing extremely physical. Tulsa's got to convert these free throws.
1-1 opportunity for Swanigan. Ray checks into the game for Smith. Swanigan's free throw rattles out. Rebound taken by Doug Taylor of Ohio. And Simmons brings it up the floor with an 11-point lead. Left side it goes for Dardis, guarded by Harrison. Looks at a cutting block, has him. Left baseline block. Blocked out of bounds by Swanigan as he put up a shot. Swanigan using that shot blocking ability. And with 13 on the shot clock, Ohio with the ball up 11. 9:21 to go first half. Simmons with the inbound pass. Looks at a cutting block, can't find an opening. Now throws it up top for Dardis. Left side for Kaminsky. Shot fake got Curtis up in the air, but did not take the three and left it for Simmons. Shot clock at 5. Dardis for 3. Nailed it. Dardis hits the 3, and it's a 14-point lead for Ohio. 28-14. Ray dribbles between his legs, leaves it for Swanigan. Layup good. And count it. A foul is called as Swanigan gets the basket. And he shouts in the direction of Frank Haith. Gets some instruction. Haith waves him back. Ray trots over to get some communication from Haith.
Ohio fans were upset about that. They thought he had position, but he was inside that new outer arc, and hence the blocking call and the bucket's good.
So Swanigan back to the free throw line. It's 28-16, Ohio. 9:01 to go first half. Subway Restaurants, the official training restaurant of Tulsa University Athletics and athletes everywhere. Power up with your favorite Subway sandwich. Subway, eat fresh. Swanigan's free throw is good, so he converts the three-point play, and it's 28-17 at the nine-minute mark.
Here comes the full-court pressure.
Pressure from Tulsa. Harrison and Swanigan trapping block, gets it to Simmons, floats one up, slammed home by Taylor. Doug Taylor takes it and throws it down for Ohio, and it's 30-17. Right wing it goes for Curtis. He traveled. Markel Curtis whistled for the violation. And at the 8:40 mark, Frank Haith stares down at the floor for a brief moment, then looks up, claps his hands together, and folds his arms as his team is down by 13.
He's got to be a little bit shocked right now. I mean, this team played so well Tuesday night. We got to get it going right here. Hopefully this pressure will get us into it.
Dardis across the timeline, left side of the floor, guarded there by Ray. Right side it goes for Gollin. Gollin will take it and bring it to Seti. Seti to block, flips it to Dardis. Shot clock at 8:07. Dardis on the left side of the floor. Guarded tightly by Burt. Goes around him and lays it in. Dardis with the basket for Ohio. It's 32-17. Ray with it on the left side of the floor. Leaves it for Harrison, lost it for a moment. Now to Swanigan, back to Harrison. Spins, goes into the lane, fouled. Dardis whistled for the foul. That's another one on Ohio, but it has been all Bobcats in the first half. 7:58 to go, and Ohio leads Tulsa 32-17 in the Virgin Islands. It's the Don Thornton Cadillac broadcast booth, and this is Golden Hurricane basketball from Learfield Sports.
Yikes. It's not good.
Welcome to Belongo Bay Beach Resort, St. Thomas, the Caribbean's most entertaining beach resort. Experience the Caribbean's most entertaining beach resort, Belongo Bay Beach Resort, St. Thomas, U.S. Virgin Islands. No passport required.
Thank you.
Welcome back to the Don Thornton Cadillac Broadcast Booth, coming to you from the University of the Virgin Islands, the Paradise Jam. It's Tulsa and Ohio, and in a surprise, Ohio not only leading but up by 15, 32-17 with 7:58 to go first half. So the Golden Hurricane with Shaq Harrison at the free throw line looking to chip away and misses the free throw. Tulsa is in the double bonus. 11 fouls already by Ohio, playing a physical style, but knocking down shots. 11 of 16 from the floor, 69%. Harrison spins one in the basket, and it's 32-18. Back the other way, Ohio. Simmons, the leading scorer for Ohio. He has 10 points.
Tulsa staying in man-to-man.
Picks up his dribble, gives it to Seti at the top of the key. Throws one inside for Campbell, draws a double team, back out to Seti, and he traveled. Another traveling violation on Ohio. A young team full of energy. It's to be expected, some shuffling of the feet at times. But Tulsa has really struggled scoring the basketball, two of its last 11.
Yeah, we just need to start making shots. I mean, the stats don't lie. We're not hitting buckets. We're not hitting free throws. Once we turn that switch and get it going, we'll be fine.
It's Taplin for Tulsa, dribbling to the right side, gets it to Curtis. Now to Burt as they weave it over to Harrison. He slashes to the free throw line and kicks it to Taplin, throws one inside to Swanigan on the left block, banks it in, and it's 32-20.
Big time spark right there by Sterling.
Taplin claps his hands together. On defense, Tulsa going up against Simmons. They bump Taplin and Simmons at the free throw line, and a foul is called on Taplin. That's the first on Sterling Taplin.
Tulsa staying there man-to-man. Frank's just looking for a lineup that's going to get it going here.
On the floor, Taplin, Curtis, Swanigan, Burt, and Harrison for Tulsa. Seti with it for Ohio. Leaves it for Simmons. Simmons will back up to the Virgin Islands Paradise Jam logo and direct traffic. Taplin follows him to the left side of the floor. Now to Kaminsky, short on the three, rebounded by Harrison. Harrison looks up. This is a long, athletic Ohio team. Again, arms all over the place as Curtis misses the three from the right side of the floor and had an arm in his face. Simmons brings it back for Ohio. Leaves it for Kaminsky. Three on the way. Goes down for Kenny Kaminsky.
Boy, it's really tough at 6'8 to be able to step out there 4 feet behind the arc and make those.
It's 35-20 Ohio. 6:25 to go first half. Harrison on right wing. Comes off a screen from Swanigan. Dribbles into traffic and he's fouled. And so Shaquille Harrison will go back to the free throw line. Down by 15. TU basketball brought to you by Basie's Roofing, the name you can trust.
The rebounding battle is extremely tight. The shooting battle is not. They are shooting the fire out of the ball.
Kaminsky has been a big part of that. Two of three. That latest three went down as the free throw goes in for Harrison to make it a 35-21 game. Smith checks in for Burt. He comes out of the game. Smith out there with Curtis, Harrison, Swanigan, and Taplin. Next one from Harrison is up and good. Shaquille makes them both. 35-22, the Ohio lead over Tulsa. 6:19 to go first half. Simmons brings it up the left side of the floor for the Bobcats. Guarded by Taplin. Dribbles to the free throw line. Now pulls up. About a 16-footer, no good. Rebound Curtis. Gets it to Harrison on the left side of the floor. The high dribble in front of the Ohio bench. He's guarded there by Dardis. Now gets it to Smith on left wing. Inside Swanigan, hook shot rolls in for Swanigan. He's had a good half, and he cuts the lead to 35-24.
Big time move by Swanigan down there. Got position, went up strong with a strong half hook.
Swanigan has 7 points. He's the co-leader with Harrison. They each have seven. It's a 35-24 Ohio lead. Seti drives right baseline. He traveled. Another traveling violation, another turnover. Tulsa basketball trying to cut in and make this a single-digit game.
Hurricane got a big-time break right now. Both Hurricane players off their feet.
He slipped on that side of the floor. Five turnovers for Ohio, two for Tulsa. Curtis drives baseline, ball goes out of bounds. It'll stay with Tulsa. 19 on the shot clock, 35-24 Ohio lead. 5:24 to go, first half.
No reason to press yet. I mean, we're down 11, but it's still first half. Plenty of time left. Get in your sets, run your stuff, start knocking down shots.
Taplin with the inbound pass for Tulsa. Throws a quick pass to a cutting Curtis. Bounce pass to Swanigan. Goes up with the left hand. No. Rebound by Harley for Ohio. Gets it to his point guard, Simmons. Left side of the floor, Simmons guarded by Curtis. He anticipates the screen. He follows Simmons around. And a foul is called as bucket. He missed the shot. He'll go to the free throw line, fouled by Curtis, his first.
This Simmons kid is a complete player, is he not?
He sure is, a sophomore. Jerron Simmons, they love him there. At Ohio University, Simmons, a 6'1", redshirt sophomore, and he makes the free throw. It's 36-24. He's had some turnover issues in the past as he makes the next free throw, but we haven't seen that much today. He has been very efficient, and he is the leading scorer in the ball game with 12 points. 37-24, the Ohio lead. Harrison bumped a couple of times, then trying to make a move to the basket. They finally call the foul on Ohio's Jordan Dardis, the 6'3 freshman guard.
They may get to 20 fouls in the first half.
Well, they're just about there.
Yeah.
In fact, they are there. 20 fouls, wow, right there. That's 13 on Ohio and 7 on Tulsa. 20 total fouls called in this first half, and we still have a lot of time. 4:58 to go. Harrison makes the free throw. It's 37-25. Harrison, 4 of 5 from the line, 2 of 5 from the floor. He has 8 points. Co-leader for the Hurricane, as that one is missed. Rebound by Kaminsky. Gets it to the guard Simmons, who drives to the left side of the floor, followed by Curtis. Floats a cross-court pass to Dardis. Knocked down on the three-point attempt. And Dardis, who airballed the three, is going to get back to the free throw line for 3 free throws.
We bailed him out right there, unfortunately. We got caught a little bit out of position, tried to make it up, ran him over.
Ball boys go over and wipe that area of the floor. Dardis walks over to the free throw line. A 12-point lead for Ohio at the 4:44 mark. Dardis with 5 points, perfect from the floor, 2 of 2, and misses the free throw. He knocked down a 3. He's been impressive. They have some good young players there.
They really do.
Ohio, 13-time NCAA tournament appearances. Made the Sweet 16 in 2012. They have good history there, and a free throw made by Dardis. He gets one more. It's 38-25 Ohio. Next one on the way from Dardis is up, and it is good.
All right, 4 minutes left for 4:43. We got to get it going right now.
Tulsa with the basketball. Taplin, right side for Curtis. Curtis bounces one inside for Smith. Smith works on the defender, throws left side. 3 missed by Taplin. Fighting underneath is Swanigan. He goes up, missed the shot, but he's fouled. Boy, Swanigan has been tough inside. And Tulsa is trying to get points any way it can. 39-25 Ohio lead at the 4:25 mark. And Swanigan going back to the free throw line. He's 2 of 4 from the charity stripe.
He brought his hard hat today. He's doing some work down there around the basket, just constantly aggressive, getting his hand on it, keeping the ball alive.
Papa John's Pizza, a proud sponsor of Tulsa University Athletics. When the Golden Hurricane wins, you'll receive 50% off your entire order. Use promo code TUWINS at papajohns.com. Free throw good by Swanigan. It's a 13-point game. 3 dribbles and a spin. Swanigan knocks it down. 12-point game, 39-27. Simmons, the leading scorer in the game. Jerron Simmons for Ohio brings it up the floor. He has 12 points. switches to his right hand, dribbles to the middle of the floor, throws left side for Kaminsky. Three ball goes down for Kenny Kaminsky. He has three of them this afternoon, and it's back to a 15-point lead. Curtis leaves it for Harrison on the left side of the floor. Harrison slashes in, leaves it for Swanigan, who slams it home with two hands. 42-29 under 4 minutes. Simmons brings it up the floor for Ohio. Calls out a play, Taplin guarding him. Goes right side, now brings it back to the free throw line, left elbow, pulls up there, jumper good for Simmons. It bounced off the front of the rim and popped into the basket, and it's 44-29. Taplin with it for Tulsa. Left side for Curtis, looks inside at Smith, had it knocked away by Harley. And timeout on the floor with 3:20 to go in the first half. It has been all Bobcats at the Virgin Islands Paradise Jam. Tulsa trailing 44-29. This is Golden Hurricane Basketball from Learfield Sports.
To experience your Virgin Islands nice, book one of our packages today.
Rated E10 for ages 10 and up.
Back at the Paradise Jam, the Don Thornton Cadillac broadcast booth with J.R. Rollo. I'm Tom Ackerman, and it has been Ohio's game. 44-29, leading Tulsa with 3:20 to go in the first half. It's been a dismal shooting half for Tulsa, 37%, 9 of 24. And for Ohio, just on fire, 14 of 21, that's 67%, and 78% from three-point range, 7 of 9.
There's just not a whole lot you can do. We've got to tighten up. Coach talked about it in the pregame. We got to be aware of the pick and pop. Well, Kaminsky's knocked down several off that right there. So I look for them maybe to go to the 3-2 zone to take that away.
It's Tulsa basketball underneath the basket with 19 on the shot clock. Harrison gets it to Curtis, to Ray Smith at the top of the key, right side for Harrison. Harrison with the pass inside to Smith on the feed from Swanigan. Harrison to Swanigan to Smith, quick passing, great play out of the timeout. It's 44-31. Simmons brings it up the floor for Ohio, dribbles to the right side of the floor. Smith picks him up. Simmons tries to go around the big man. He carried it. A turnover for Ohio, back to Tulsa.
Great job by Smith guarding the little guy.
6'1 guard Simmons going up against the much bigger 6'7 Smith. Smith has it, gets it to Curtis on the right side of the floor. Now to Swanigan at the top of the key, leaves it for Ray. Ray dribbles out of trouble to Smith at the top, reverses it. Right side for Harrison. Puts it on the deck with the left hand. Gets it to Swanigan. Left side for Curtis. He tried to make a move, and he was fouled on his way to the basket.
Tulsa seems to figure it out of the pick and roll. We're able to, once the picker releases to the basket, he's open more times than not. We've scored on that a few times here down the stretch.
Don Thornton Cadillac, proud to be a sponsor of University of Tulsa Athletics. As Curtis misses the free throw, we're happy to be coming to you from the Don Thornton Cadillac broadcast booth as Tulsa came to the Virgin Islands coming off a dramatic win over number 9 Wichita State. And so far, not the start they wanted, trailing 44-31 to Ohio, now 44-32 as Curtis splashes the free throw. Simmons brings it up the floor for Ohio, guarded by Ray, left-handed dribble. Now to Dardis on left wing. Harrison is on him. Comes off a screen from Taylor. Right side for Simmons. And now it's Kaminsky. Kaminsky has been dangerous shooting the three. Now he throws up a wild shot, but he is fouled. And Kaminsky is going to go to the free throw line. Just, it has been a foul fest, but they are drawing them. And that one was another one that Kaminsky leaned into the defender, and he gets to the line.
You can tell that the Hurricane are worried about the three-point. We're trying to get out on it now, but you got to have a little more discipline and stay down on that shot.
The officials are looking at a replay. I think they want to determine two or three free throws on that attempt from Kaminsky. Initially, they put up the three signal, but was his foot on the line when he put up what was just a heave that he knew he was getting fouled and could get to the line?
Kaminsky definitely looks the part today. We talked to their media guys before the game a little bit. He's a transfer from Michigan State. Third game, he looks like he's the real deal.
He had a labrum issue in the offseason, but he's come out of that, and after being cold early in the year from three-point range, he has been anything but. He was shooting under 10%, just 8% from three-point range coming into the game. But they know his strength.
He only averaging 10.5 points coming to the game, and he's already got 12 going to the line for free throws now.
12 points for Kaminsky on 3 of 4 shooting from three-point range.
So the goal for the Hurricane now, you're down 12 with 2 minutes. You want to get it under 10. You want to get that lead down single digits. I think they said 3.
I'm pretty sure they kept that at 3, and they did. So Kaminsky, and they did. They just confirmed that. 3 free throws for Kaminsky. And that one is good. It's 45-32. Ohio in the lead. Kaminsky's next one is up, and it is good.
Boy, he's got a pure stroke.
He sure does. He'll get another one. Came into the game perfect from the free throw line. In fact, Ohio ranked 9th in the country coming into the game, 82% from the free throw line, 44 of 54 coming into the game, and today they're 11 of 13. Kaminsky with his third, and he splashes that one in. It's 47-32. It's back to a 15-point lead for Ohio. Curtis on the right side of the floor, guarded tightly, bounces one for Swanigan, finds some room in the lane and lays it in from the center of the lane. Brandon Swanigan now with a big day. It's 47-34. Swanigan with 13 of those 34 points. Simmons to Dardis, guarded by Harrison, knocked it away into the backcourt. Ohio will keep possession, shot clock down to 13. Simmons dribbles to the top of the key, now goes left side for Dardis, into the lane, floats one off the glass, and it rolls in. No, they are going to count it, but a foul is called underneath. They're going to count the basket, but call a foul against Ohio. Underneath, and free throws coming for Tulsa. They're going to whistle that foul on Doug Taylor, his second, in the lane with a push. I believe they said they were going to count the basket. They have not thus far. 49-34 on the scoreboard and on the official stats.
What did he call? Oh, here we go. We're getting into the lane now. Now, it's unfortunate. It looked like the Ohio guy got his hand in the basket. I thought he was waving
it
off.
Yep, they did. That's exactly what happened. They called it inside. Here's Dardis.
Right. Shooting woes continue.
Burt misses the free throw. Dardis on the floor for Ohio along with Kaminsky. And Harrison is out there for Tulsa with Ray standing next to Simmons. These players have been out on the floor for most of these minutes. And Simmons will bring it up the floor in a 49-35 game. Ohio in the lead. Simmons takes it all the way in. Swanigan altered the shot. Might have gotten a piece of it. Long pass the other way to Harrison. Missed the layup. Rebound taken by Kaminsky. Back the other way is Ohio. It's 49-35. Kaminsky pulls up from three and hits it. Kaminsky hits the three from the top of the key, and Ohio makes it a 52-35 game. Curtis at the free throw line, drives in left hand, missed the shot. Foul is called against Ohio. They're going to whistle Ohio's James Gollin with that foul.
17-point lead. I mean, we seem to be able to hit nothing, and everything for them is going in.
Players with hands on hips, they've been out there a long time. 101 left in the first half, a 52-35 lead. Curtis's free throw is good. Tulsa basketball brought to you by Tulsa Country Club. One club for everyone, 1 mile from everything. Next one from Curtis is good. Curtis cuts the lead to 52-37 with a minute to go. Simmons with it for Ohio. Ray is on him. Dribbles to the left side of the floor. Now spins away from him. Now goes to the top of the key. Bounce pass to a cutting Gollin. No, knocked away into the hands of Burt. Now to Harrison. Layup is no good. He can't get it to fall. The rebound by Mom Premier for Ohio. And Simmons takes a timeout as he crosses the timeline near the scorer's table with 33 seconds left on the clock. And Ohio with a 52-37 lead on Tulsa. Tulsa basketball brought to you by the R Bar, 3421 South Peoria Avenue, proud supporters of TU Athletics. And by TTCU, the credit union. Game 52-37. 33 seconds on the clock. Ohio called the timeout. Back out on the floor. Dardis to inbound the ball for Ohio. And now a discussion at the scorer's table on the substitutions. But Dardis and Simmons are out there along with Mom Premier, Kaminsky, and Gollin for Ohio. For Tulsa, it's Burt, Curtis, Swanigan, Harrison, and Ray, who is guarding Simmons. Shot clock at 15, game clock at 26. Simmons continues to dribble in the middle of the floor. Ray now backs off. Simmons to the right side of the floor. Shot clock at 5. Kaminsky swings the left side for Gollin. Puts one up in the lane. No, short. Gets his own rebound. Kick out for Simmons. 3 missed. Kaminsky gets the offensive board. Cross-court pass for Simmons. Now driving baseline, Dardis, and he's fouled by Swanigan with 2.4 seconds left. Ohio with offensive rebound after offensive board and a 15-point advantage and a chance to extend it to 17. It's Dardis at the free throw line. First one is up and good. Jordan Dardis makes it a 16-point game. He has 10 points. Kenny Kaminsky checks out with 18 points in the first half, 4 of 5 from 3, 6 of 6 from the free throw line. Next run from Dardis is good. Makes the free throw. It's 54-37 Ohio with 2.4 seconds on the clock, and Frank Haith will try to draw up one last play to get a bucket and get into the locker room. It has been a tough first half for Tulsa, shooting 39% from the floor, 11 of 28. And Ohio, 61.5% from the floor and 8 of 10 from three-point range for 54 points. At halftime, we'll hear from our coaching staff from Tulsa. We'll also check in. We'll get a football update from the play-by-play voice, Bruce Howard. I'm Tom Ackerman at the Paradise Jam of the U.S. Virgin Islands. University of the Virgin Islands, a great host here. But right now, Not a good first half for Tulsa. The inbound pass to Swanigan, back to Harrison. He throws a three in the air. They won't count it. It missed. He let it go just after the buzzer, and Tulsa trails 54-37 to Ohio University at halftime here at the Paradise Jam. We'll take a break. We'll have much more halftime activity in just a moment. You're listening to Golden Hurricane Basketball from Learfield Sports.
Rated E10 for ages 10 and up.
Experience your Virgin Islands nice. Book one of our packages today. So nice, so
nice. Welcome to Belongo Bay Beach Resort, St. Thomas, the Caribbean's most entertaining beach resort. Experience the Caribbean's most entertaining beach resort, Belongo Bay Beach Resort, St. Thomas, U.S. Virgin Islands. No passport required. Welcome to Belongo Bay Beach Resort, St. Thomas.
Second half at the Paradise Jam. It's the Don Thornton Cadillac broadcast booth with J.R. Rollo. I'm Tom Ackerman. Tulsa with the basketball to start, down 17 as they take the floor, and Rashad Smith slashes into the lane for the first possession and misses. Rebound taken by Ohio. Simmons floats one, Wright intercepts it. It was intended for Campbell, and Wright knocked it out of bounds. It'll stay Ohio ball.
Great job by Wright getting back on defense to break that up.
When it comes to Rocky Mountain Cold Coors Light, remember 21 means 21. With great beer comes great responsibility. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. Kincaid Coach Lines, the official charter bus of TU Athletics. Log on to KincaidCoach.com for information on all our charter services. It was all Ohio in the first half. Let's see what Tulsa has in store for the Bobcats in our final 20 minutes. 54-37, Ohio in the lead. Right now, an injury on the floor as they are attending to Rashad Smith. He is seated and favoring his left leg. So they'll take a look at that and spend a little bit of time attending to Rashad. Training staff, medical staff out on the floor for Tulsa. Rashad has been so important to this team, and they are now going to help him off the floor. He is not putting any weight on that left foot.
That is not a good sign right there.
They're going to help him as he drags the left toe and hops on his right foot, being helped off the floor by the Tulsa medical staff. So
I didn't see any contact or anything that caused
either.
That injury.
It could have been a slippage, and without the benefit of a replay monitor at the moment, don't see it. But nevertheless, a tough moment for Tulsa as they take Rashad Smith to the locker room. So Ohio with the lead, a 17-point lead, 30 seconds into the second half. Simmons with it for Ohio, throws inside to Campbell, backs in on Wright, doesn't give an inch and pushes Campbell beyond the three-point line. Now to Seti at the top of the key, leaves it for Simmons. Shot clock at 5. Simmons stops, picks up his dribble, puts up a shot, missed it from the left elbow. Here comes Harrison. Harrison, quick bounce pass to Woodard, goes up hard and gets fouled. He'll go to the free throw line. Woodard, and Tulsa's bench stands and applauds as the Golden Hurricane have to find a way to get back into this game.
Well, that's exactly how we have to do it. We like to get up and down the court, get out in transition. Right there is a great pass by Shaquille. We got to get Woodard going.
Woodard with the left-handed shot. He spins it. He lets it fly and makes it. Woodard's free throw cuts it to 54-38. Checking into the game, Mon Premier for Ohio. Campbell comes out of the game. And we were told before the game that if there was one issue with Campbell, it was he gets into foul trouble, and lo and behold, he gets his third right there. Three fouls on Antonio Campbell.
He's a load. Without him out of the game, we should be able to score around the basket.
Well, they've been going inside. Swanigan has been strong for Tulsa with 13 points to lead the way. And he's not in the game now as this one is turned over. They're going to call a turnover in the middle of the floor. Mon Premier. And so back the other way. It'll go for Tulsa. Burt with the inbound pass to Harrison. Burt is out on the floor with him, along with Wright and Woodard. And battling with them is Ray. That's the group out on the floor for Tulsa as a kickball is called against Ohio. 21 seconds on the shot clock, 54-39 Ohio lead at the 18:47 mark, and Harrison will inbound it from the Tulsa bench. Gets it to Wright, back to Harrison. Guarded on left wing, now to Wright. Backs in on Mont Premier, now out to Harrison. Harrison slashes into the lane, puts one up and scores. Shaquille Harrison scores, and it's 54-41.
Here comes the full court pressure. Hurricane extending it, looking for a spark.
Ohio tries to break it, tripping and falling is Seti, but a foul is called. They whistle the foul on Ray. He doesn't like the call, but he'll simmer down on the protest.
Truth is, Seti had lost control.
He did. He tripped really over his own feet.
That's what it looked like to me.
Call it on Ray. It happened right in front of us. Simmons has it on left wing. Dribbles into pressure. Now leaves it for his big forward, Mon Premier, who missed it. And back the other way is Harrison. He throws one off the side of the backboard, but he was fouled. He went in hard. He gets a chest bump from Woodard, another from Ray. Burt comes over and slaps five with him, and the Tulsa bench loves it.
In just under 2 minutes, looks like the Hurricane are for real this second half.
They've come out with fire. Wouldn't you love to have been a fly on the wall in that locker room with Frank Haith?
I'm sure he had a few words for him at halftime.
Harrison, the left-handed free throw, made it. 54-42. Good start for Tulsa. We'll try to get an update on Rashad Smith when we can.
Looks like a different team so far this half.
Harrison, next free throw is up and good. Harrison made them both. It's 54-43.
Back in our full court press.
Harley to Seti, back to Simmons, bringing it up the floor for Ohio. Woodard guarding him all the way across the timeline. Woodard still on Simmons. Simmons with it at the top of the key. Low dribble, lost it. Stripped away by Woodard. Up ahead to Harrison. Lays it up. No foul call. They wanted a foul, but it was clean contact with the ball on the miss by Harrison. Scamper out of the way because they were cleaning the floor when Harrison came barreling through, and they barely got out of the way. Seti with it on the right baseline. Now to Kaminsky on right wing. Guarded by Ray. You can see the intensity from Tulsa. Burt guarding Simmons at the top of the key. Now Wright is on him. They throw inside to Taylor. It's knocked away. They're going to have a shot clock violation. Great defense as the shot clock expired. And it'll be Tulsa basketball.
Fabulous defense. Looks like a completely different team on defense. We're out hedging on screens. That time Simmons had to beat two of us.
54-43 is the Ohio lead, but Tulsa was down by 17 at the half, and now Pepe.
That's huge right
He's
there.
He's been great for them, and Dardis, right side, Kaminsky missed the three. Rebound taken by Woodard. Tulsa running. Ray will back it up. He gets it to Burt. Three on the way. Missed short by Burt. Rebound taken and handed to Simmons. Simmons drives in on three. Tulsa.
Oh, we got to do a little better job of moving him out of there. And here comes Mr. Swanigan.
So Swanigan comes into the game. Wright and Ray check out. That's three fouls on DeAndre Wright. Is happening now. Visit LandRoverTulsa.com. Land Rover, above and beyond. Free throw is made by Taylor, and it's back to a 14-point game, 59-45. Harrison comes off the screen, now goes into the lane, and he's fouled. A foul called against Ohio, and that's already five fouls on Ohio in this half. That one whistled on Taylor. Another big man gets whistled for his third foul. So a timeout on the floor. 59-45 is the Ohio lead. This is Golden Hurricane basketball from Learfield Sports. You have to assume an ankle injury. It's been taped as Harrison comes back the other way and throws down a dunk in transition. for Tulsa, and it's 59-47. Boy, that was quick by Shaq.
And Ohio coming right back with Campbell, number 33, with three fouls.
Campbell is in there, sets a screen on Harrison to free Simmons. Now back to Campbell, fakes the three. Swanigan stayed with him. Simmons with it for Ohio. Harrison guarding him along with Burt. That leaves Kaminsky open, and he hits a three.
We cannot leave him open. We just continue to do so.
A three-point bucket by Kenny Kaminsky. He does it again. It's 62-47 in favor of Ohio. And for Kaminsky, that's five threes, five of seven from three-point range. He has 21 points. Foul called on Ohio. Dardis whistled for the violation. 62-47, the Ohio lead at the 14-47 mark. And so Harrison goes back to the free throw line. The sixth foul on Ohio. Harrison with 14 points. He's Tulsa's leading scorer. 4 of 11 shooting from the floor, but 6 of 8 from the free throw line, and misses that one. 6 of 9.
No reason to panic yet, but there needs to be a little sense of urgency here. We've got to convert from the line when the clock has stopped.
Well, they came flying out of the locker room with energy, but in the end, with the three-point baskets, it remains a 15-point game, and Harrison misses both free throws. Campbell with the rebound to Simmons for Ohio, up by 15, 14:40 to go. Simmons, guarded by Harrison, bounces it to Kaminsky. Burt is on him, pass goes inside. Swanigan stole it, but lost it, and Laster just ends up laying it in with an easy basket in the lane. It's a 17-point game, 64-47. Ball fake, Woodard goes to the basket. No, it was blocked by Campbell partially, and he came up with the ball. Now to Simmons, right wing Kaminsky, three on the way, in and out. Rebounded by Swanigan. Swanigan tried to throw it to Burt. It was knocked out of bounds. Dardis, and it'll stay Tulsa ball.
Coach may need a timeout here in a little bit to regroup. The guys just seem to have lost their focus.
14-minute mark approaching. 64-47, Ohio leads Tulsa. Ray dribbles between his legs, now goes into the lane, kicks it out for Curtis on left wing. Up top for Burt, three on the way, no good. Rebound Campbell for Ohio. Flips it over to Simmons. Simmons with a high dribble in front of the Ohio bench. Dribbles around a screen. Campbell on Ray. Simmons still with it. Goes now to Laster. Back to Simmons at the top of the key. Left wing Laster looks in at Kaminsky, gets it to him. Kaminsky on the smaller Ray just pulls up, shoots a jumper, no. Rebound Swanigan. Now to Curtis on the left side of the floor. One on three. Curtis going to take it all the way in, and he's fouled. And I believe that is going to be a foul on Campbell, and it is his fourth.
That's a huge foul right there. He definitely has to go to the bench now, and he creates a lot of havoc for us down by the basket.
It is indeed the fourth foul on Antonio Campbell. Curtis at the free throw line. Tulsa is down 17. Curtis misses short. Free throws have been an issue. Tulsa has missed 10 of them. 18 of 28, 64%. DeAndre Wright checks into the game. Swanigan will take a seat. Campbell also exits the game. Mom Premier back in there for Ohio. Campbell with four fouls. Curtis missed the free throw.
That's the last four free throws we've missed now.
That's 11 misses on the day for Tulsa from the free throw line. Simmons guarded by Ray on the left side of the floor. Dribbles between his legs, now drives in, puts one up, teardrop, no, missed the shot. Foul before Mom Premier stuffed in an offensive rebound. They're going to call a foul against Curtis. Markel Curtis whistled for his second.
Well, we keep saying it, but, you know, the time is now. Time is starting to become of the essence. We got to get going.
Ohio has been very impressive in their execution. Simmons makes the free throw. And it's an 18-point game, 65-47. Tulsa, again, cold from the floor, two of its last eight. really one of its last six. Just a tough day all around. Simmons makes the free throw. It's 66-47. Harrison has it for Tulsa. Dribbles with the left hand to the left elbow. Tries to get around the defender, Dardis. Puts it off the left side of the backboard. Gets it back. Harrison bounce pass out left wing for Woodard. To Burt, reverses it to Curtis, goes baseline. Now feeds Harrison to Woodard, reverse to Burt, back to Curtis on right wing. Good defense by Ohio, shot clock at three. Curtis goes in with the left hand, no. Tipped up, no by Harrison. Second effort by Shaq goes. Boy, these baskets have been tough to get.
They are.
66-49.
Ball just doesn't want to go in sometimes.
Simmons has it for Ohio. Picks up his dribble. Harrison all over him. Gets it to Kaminsky. Burt is guarding him. Kaminsky tries to drive. Can't. Stolen by Harrison. Shaq gets it taken from the side by Kaminsky. And then he wrapped his arm around him and fouled him. So Kaminsky's whistled for the foul. And Harrison, who lost it for a moment, was at least able to get fouled. Now the officials. Brought to you by the Williams Charity Stripe. With each free throw that Tulsa makes this season, Williams will donate to Tulsa STEM Alliance. Harrison at the free throw line.
The effort is there. It's just, it's almost like we can't control the ball, can't hold on to it, can't quite make layups, can't make free throws. We gotta pick it up.
Seti checking back in for Ohio, replacing Kaminsky, who just picked up his second foul. Seti is out there with Dardis, Mompremier, and Laster, along with Simmons, who's been terrific. Harrison makes the free throw, and here comes Rashad Smith back into the game. How nice is that to
Boy,
see?
Boy, that is good news right there. Must have been a cramp or something, and Doc Meyerman's been around this for a long time. Got him right.
He was favoring that left leg and could hardly put any weight on it, but he's back out there. Sandwiched between a couple of Ohio players on the free throw line, and Harrison makes the free throw. 66-51, nearing the 12-minute mark here in the ball game at the Paradise Islands, Paradise Jam in the Virgin Islands, and Simmons is fouled as he was bringing it up the floor. Curtis got him. That's his third.
An animated Simmons there helped the referee call that one, I believe.
That he did. He's kind of wiping his left eye as if he was poked in the eye. Perhaps he was. Curtis comes out of the game. And in there is Woodard along with Ray, Smith, Wright, and Harrison. The starting lineup for the Hurricanes. Simmons on the right side of the floor. Gets it to Dardis. Three on the way. No good from the top of the key. Laster grabs the rebound for Ohio. Seti has it for the Bobcats. Gets back to Dardis for another three-ball attempt. No. And the rebound taken by Seti again. Ohio just continues to rebound the basketball on the offensive glass now. A big day for them. That's six offensive boards, but they've out-rebounded Tulsa 28-22. Simmons from the left elbow hits the shot, and he's fouled. And Ohio gets another big bucket. They'll go to the free throw line with Jerron Simmons putting on a show.
This Ohio team is a very well-coached team. They execute extremely well.
Timeout on the floor. It's Ohio leading Tulsa 68-51. You're listening to Golden Hurricane.
Experience your Virgin Islands nice. Book one of our packages today.
So nice, so nice. Sweet, sweet Santa Mas nice. So nice, so nice.
Check, check, check. One, two, three. Yeah. in the Virgin Islands with J.R. Rallo. I'm Tom Ackerman. 11:34 to go in the game, and it's been all Ohio. 68-51 leading Tulsa. Tulsa fans, when it comes to Rocky Mountain Cold Coors Light, 21 means 21. With great beer comes great responsibility. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. Tulsa shooting 35% from the floor. 15 of 42, 1 of 8 from three-point range. Ohio has buried 9 threes today, 9 of 16 for 56%. And they're shooting 54% from the floor overall. Now they're at the free throw line where Jerron Simmons makes the free throw, converting a three-point play. And they have been spectacular from the free throw line, 18 of 20. You see why they're ranked in the top 10 in the country from that spot. Ray leaves one for Wright, lost it. Seti stole it away. He goes one-on-one with Wright, and he's fouled hard. And both Wright and Seti go flying into the baseline as he was not going to allow Treg Seti to throw one down in transition. But he'll go to the free throw line with a 69-51 lead.
Down 18 with 11 minutes left. We got to get it going now.
Tulsa basketball brought to you by Pepsi. All for Hurricane.
It would definitely help if they miss a few shots, too.
Well, certainly it has been, I mean, in this half, Ohio is 5 of 13, but they still knocked down a killer three in this half by Kaminsky. When Tulsa was getting on a little bit of a roll, and it just iced them. 70 to 51 on the made free throw by Seti. Harrison fouled by Dardis as he was working on the freshman. Shaq will go to the free throw line as another foul is whistled on Ohio. That's 9 team fouls this half. One more, and it's double bonus time for Tulsa. Harrison has 18 points on 5 of 14 shooting. Dardis comes out of the game for Ohio. And Harrison will shoot free throws. This one is good. He'll get another one-on-one opportunity. Burt comes into the game. Curtis checks out.
When you're not shooting well from the perimeter, it makes it very difficult to penetrate because their defense will sag down and help out. And that's exactly what they've been doing, making it hard on Shaq.
Harrison at the free throw line. Makes this, it'll be 20 points for Shaq today. And he does. Shaquille makes the shot. 20 points for Harrison. It's 70 to 53. Nearing the 11 minute mark. Pressure from Ray on Harley, but they get rid of it. And now a travel is called as Laster received the pass from Harley and shuffled his feet. So again, Ohio tends to do it. They turn it over, they travel a lot, and they've done it here today. But they have made shots and the Hurricane has not. Harrison dribbles to the left elbow, dribbles into the lane, and is swatted away by the big man, Wadley Mompremier for Ohio.
Exactly what I was talking about there. They had three guys around the basket. We need to find Woodard for the three.
Taplin throws one in, and laying it up and in is Harrison on a great feed and great inbounds play. Taplin to Harrison. He's fouled. He'll go to the line.
Shaq Harrison trying to take it upon himself here to bring us back.
Harrison with 22 points. Well, it's a 15-point game. It's been as many as 19. Harrison spins it. Free throw is good. Shaq makes the free throw. It's 70 to 56. Both teams cold from the floor lately. Ohio, one of its last five. Tulsa, two of its last eight. Ohio's committed 10 fouls. Tulsa in the double bonus from here on out. Full court pressure. Picking up his dribble is Simmons, but he's able to break the press. Gets it to Laster, now back to Simmons. Double team to Laster, tries to walk on Harrison, and he walks. He tried to get past Harrison and shuffled his feet. A travel, great defense, great intensity.
The full court pressure into the half court trap is really creating some problems for Ohio.
This is when we see perhaps some of the younger players of Ohio starting to get a little winded and see which team is conditioned and which team is not as conditioned. 70-56, Ohio with the lead. Harrison dribbles to the top of the key, leaves it right side for Woodard, fakes a three, drives baseline, puts up a shot from 12 feet, goes off the glass.
Back into the full court pressure.
Woodard makes it a 12-point game. Dardis has to call a timeout on the baseline as he couldn't find anyone with the full court pressure. Has to burn a timeout, and Tulsa feeling like it's back in this game with 70-58, a lot of work to do, but made up a lot of ground quickly.
You know, we haven't played that well this game, and we're still only down 12 with 10:22 left. Now have the momentum.
We'll take a timeout. You're listening to Golden Hurricane Basketball from Learfield Sports.
Experience the Caribbean's most entertaining beach resort, Belongo Bay Beach Resort, St. Thomas, U.S. Virgin Islands. No passport required.
Tulsa gets the ball down 12.
They are really flying around out there right now, creating chances for us.
Come see what's new at your local Subway restaurant. Try one of their signature subs or create your own masterpiece. Subway, train hard, eat fresh. 70-58, Ohio leads Tulsa at the 10-minute mark. Slashing in and scoring is Shaq Harrison. Harrison now with 25 points. He lays one in and cuts this lead to 10.
Foul on Woodard, it looks like. Now they're in the bonus.
Indeed, Woodard whistled for the foul right off the made basket by Harrison. So Simmons, who took the inbound pass, will go to the free throw line. Seven team fouls on Tulsa. Ohio has already committed 10. In the double bonus is Tulsa. One and one, first one made by Simmons. It's 71-60.
Looked like they gave that last foul to Taplin.
Taplin checks out of the game. And Ray comes in. They do. They give that to Taplin. That's his third. Free throw missed. Scramble for it. Woodard is able to get it to Harrison across the timeline. 71-60, under 10 minutes. Plenty of time for the Hurricane to make a move here. Woodard with the left-handed dribble to the right elbow to the free throw line. Gets it to Harrison. Bounce pass goes inside. Swanigan missed, but he's fouled, and he'll go to the free throw line. Oh, he wanted that one.
Great ball movement there, and a great job by Swanigan to establish a position down by the basket.
Brandon Swanigan back to the free throw line where he's 3 of 4 today. He has 13 points and 4 rebounds. Swanigan's free throw is no good. long and to the left. St. Francis Health System, a proud sponsor of TU Athletics. For more information, visit stfrancis.com. Swanigan takes a deep breath. Dribbles three times, spins it. It is up and good. Swanigan took his time and made the free throw. 71-61. It's a 10-point game. Get a stop here, get it into single digits. Burt fouls Simmons, who leaps over him after Burt committed the foul, and Simmons will leap and bound his way to the free throw line.
Looks like we're in a kind of a full court man-to-man right now with some run and jump type stuff, and it's definitely creating havoc, but we got to keep from fouling them.
Simmons at the free throw line, and he makes the front end of a 1-1.
Especially with this bunch shooting over 80% from the line.
They have been fantastic again. Simmons with the make now has 22 points. Misses that one. Rebound taken by Burt. Throws right side of the floor to Harrison. Into the lane. Couldn't find an open man, Woodard. And now here comes Harley back the other way for Ohio. Bounce pass to Simmons. He's fouled. And Woodard came over and got a piece of him. So Simmons is going to go back to the line. He has 21 points, 7 of 9 from the free throw line. Ohio is 21 of 26 from the stripe, 80%. Simmons makes that one to make it a 73-61 ball game.
We've got to limit the empty possessions moving forward.
Next one from Simmons is good. 74-61.
That's a foul on Kaminsky right there.
Yeah, they whistle Kaminsky on the foul in the lane. And come over and tell the scorer's table what he did there. He hooked the Tulsa player, Burt, with his right arm, and Burt is going to go to the line for two shots. 74-61. Got to make these free throws. Burt made it.
That one was pure. Needs to make the second one. It enables us to set up our full court press.
Tulsa is 25 of 37 from the line, 67%. Next one from Burt. Good. 74-63, 9:26 on the clock. Full court pressure from Tulsa. Ray and Woodard on Simmons, and now they back off as Ray is guarding Simmons, with Woodard keeping an eye on the situation, but also on Dardis, the freshman guard. They move away from Simmons, and now Burt is on him. Right side for Dardis, with Harrison on Dardis. Now Simmons, right wing it goes for Taylor. Back to Simmons, shot clock at 5. Simmons driving in the lane, puts up a wild shot. Blocking foul is going to be called on Ray.
Not quite sure what to say on that. Simmons was clearly out of control. Could have gone either way there.
They call it on Ray, and Simmons is back to the line again, working on a 23-point day. 74-63, the Ohio lead on Tulsa with 8:59 to go. The Eastern Oklahoma Orthopedic Center is a recognized center of excellence for orthopedic care and sports medicine in the Tulsa community, and EOC is the provider of the official team physicians of TU Athletics. EOOC.com. Simmons makes the free throw.
We're going to have to find a way to keep him off the line.
He has been almost automatic, 10 of 12. Next one is up and good. A remarkable 25 of 30 from the free throw line for Ohio. Woodard with a shot from the free throw line goes down. A two-pointer for Woodard, a high arcing shot at 76-65. Woodard has 8. Simmons in the lane, pops, misses short. Scramble for the rebound. Taylor had his hand on it and tipped it to Harley for Ohio, and they maintain possession. Now Dardis driving baseline, feeds inside to Taylor. Ball goes out of bounds. What's the call? It's going to stay with Ohio.
Unfortunately, it looked like Shaq was on the ground and out of bounds when the ball hit him.
Ray checks out of the game. Markel Curtis is back in. Curtis in there with Woodard, Harrison, Swanigan, and Burt. 76-65, Ohio leads Tulsa, 8:24 to go. Foul is called.
Yeah, it looked like Burt held him there when he was trying to
call
go to the
baseline. Hold on, Burt. And so back to the free throw line is Ohio, and it's going to be Seti. That's three on Burt. Seti makes it.
Both teams in the double bonus already.
Next one coming for Seti. It's up and no good. Long rebound ripped down by Swanigan, and a foul is called on Ohio as Swanigan came swooping in for the rebound.
What happened?
Well, they initially did, and then they're going to say that it's going to stay Tulsa ball. I believe they set a lane violation instead of a foul. So it goes to Tulsa, 77-65, the Ohio lead with 8:24 to go. Still time to get into this game. Curtis drives in, takes a bruise from Mom Premier, and he'll go to the line.
A great way to come back in a game is to score points on the free throw line when the clock is stopped. It's time for Tulsa to convert.
Curtis will go to the line. He has struggled there today, 3 of 6. It's up in the air and it's good for Markel Curtis. 77-66. TU fans, make sure to come out Monday nights for the Frank Haith Radio Call-In Show, live at the Rusty Crane, 109 North Detroit Avenue in downtown Tulsa. On your new radio home for TU basketball, Big Country 99.5. Full court pressure from Tulsa, and scrambling and saving it for Tulsa is Woodard. They get it to Burt. Three ball goes down for Pat Burt. He knocks down a three from the left baseline and cuts this lead to 7. It's 77-70 at the 8-minute mark. Inbound pass to Simmons. They're struggling with the pressure. Simmons, guarded by Harrison, crosses the timeline. Oh, Burt on a great feed, a great save by Woodard, a great steal, and the pressure changes the game. It's 77-70. Here's Seti to Simmons. Simmons on right wing with the shot clock at 10. He'll launch a three and missed it short. Rebound Curtis to Harrison. Shaq across the timeline. They settle down. 7.5 minutes to go. Curtis on left wing. Dribbles to the top of the key. To Harrison on right wing. Now to Woodard. Tries to drive on Simmons. Pulls back for three. Missed it. Rebound Curtis. Markel spins. Feeds Woodard. Left wing goes for Burt. Lost the handle. Stolen away by Harley of Ohio. And now to Simmons.
Great opportunity there for the Hurricane.
7-point game. It was a 19-point lead by Ohio. The Hurricane slowly chipping away. Under 7 minutes to go. Simmons has it at the top of the key for Ohio. He wipes some sweat away from his eyebrow. Now he pulls up from the left elbow and missed. Rebound taken by Woodard. Chance to cut it to 5, maybe 4. Woodard slipped, lost the handle. Burt can't get it. And it's to Seti for Ohio, now to Harley. Back to Seti, now to Simmons. Simmons calls out a play with 6.5 minutes to go, and they wipe that spot on the floor in the lane. Simmons on left wing. He wants some movement. Seti has it, backs in on Burt. Offensive foul called on Seti.
Great job by Burt. Seti loves to lower that shoulder, and he took full advantage.
Burt took the charge, and in the Hurricane back in this game. 77-70 is the Ohio lead with 6:22 to go. You're listening to Golden Hurricane Basketball from Learfield Sports. Paradise Jam has been terrific. The University of Tulsa, represented here by their faithful. Florida State is in this tournament, as well as South Carolina, Indiana State, Hofstra, Norfolk State, DePaul, and right here, Tulsa and Ohio going head-to-head in a great ball game, 77-70. The Ohio lead, Woodard misses a three, rebound by Swanigan, and a new possession. Curtis thought about a three from the left wing, instead he goes inside to Swanigan, working on Campbell, who has four fouls, and Swanigan hits it and cuts it to five.
He elevated so high for that half hook.
77-72, the Ohio lead with under 6 minutes to go. We're at the 5:50 mark. Frank Haith in a crouch in front of the Tulsa bench, watching his defense. Simmons, the bounce pass left side for Kaminsky. The three-point threat picks up his dribble. Whistle inside.
Swanigan not happy about that one. Thinks Campbell pushed off.
They're going to call a foul on Swanigan, his second. And that means free throw opportunity, two of them coming for Campbell.
Looks like he's only a 50% shooter. Hopefully that bodes true here.
Well, what a shot that was by Swanigan. That is a Don Thornton Cadillac of plays. Let me tell you, the Cadillac of plays, Don Thornton Cadillac. Brandon Swanigan has 16 points. He has played like a man today. Campbell misses both free throws.
This is a huge possession right here for the Hurricane.
Here comes Shaq. Harrison across the timeline. Guarded by Dardis. Comes off a screen. Puts up a shot. Missed it long. Dardis gets the rebound. Now to Simmons. Very confident sophomore point guard for Ohio. Jerron Simmons guarded by Harrison. Picks up his dribble, goes to Kaminsky left side. In it goes to Campbell, lost the handle, scramble for it, and a jump ball is called.
Great defense by Swanigan there to get his hands on the ball and force that jump ball.
With the alternating possession, it is Ohio ball. 13 on the shot clock. Simmons bounce pass to Harley, and a foul is called as Harrison came flying in for what would have been a one-on-one opportunity with Kaminsky on the other end, but instead Burt was whistled for the foul, creating that loose ball opportunity. So Burt gets his fourth foul called on him, and Harley is at the line for Ohio. Free throw is good for Kyrie Harley. 78-72, the Ohio lead, 5:14 to go. Harley makes the second. It's back to a 7-point lead for Ohio. Tulsa has climbed back, down 19 of this half. Cut it to 5, it's now 7. Burt, playing with 4 fouls, gets it to Harrison. To Swanigan at the top of the key. Left wing for Woodard. Tries to get it back to Swanigan, threw it out of bounds. Curtis diving, tried to save it, but wasn't there in time. And Woodard, just with the miscommunication with Swanigan, thought that Swanigan was going to be there and threw it to nobody. 79-72, 4:53 to go. Here's Simmons up the floor for Ohio. Harrison guarding him. Simmons, right-handed dribble, dribbles low into the lane, goes in on Curtis and scores, and he's fouled. Curtis puts his arms up in the air saying, "What did I do?" The officials say, "You fouled him," and that's his fourth.
Well, considering Simmons made all the contact and we were just standing there, I tend to agree with him on that one, but we've got to stop this run from Ohio right now.
Jerron Simmons with 27 points, misses the free throw, rebounded by Harrison. Harrison quickly, the outlet pass to Curtis. He feeds Burt for three. Good, it's Woodard rather with the three. Right in front of the Tulsa bench, Woodard hits the three, and a timeout is called. 81-75 with 4:33 to go, and once again,
rated E10 for ages 10 and up.
6-point game with 4.5 to go. You have to feel pretty good about your situation at this point. Take a quick break. We'll be back in a moment. It's Golden Hurricane Basketball from the Express.
rated E10 for ages 10 and up.
Should be all right. Back at the Paradise Jam, while we were away, a quick transition basket by Tulsa has cut it to four. A dunk by Shaq Harrison makes it 81-77. Tulsa trailing Ohio with 3.5 minutes to go. Scramble for it, stolen away by Harrison. He has it across the timeline. He's back in transition, throws it down with two hands. Shaq Harrison with a thunderous slam to cut it to two. 81-79 is Harrison, a man possessed.
I'm speechless after that.
In traffic, he throws down a two-handed slam, and Shaquille Harrison has put Tulsa within 2 points with 3:12 to go. 29 points for Harrison. Ohio once up by 19, now up by just two.
Shaq Harrison is a man possessed, as you said, and 29 points. I mean, he has taken this team on his back. He will not.
Had gone quiet. Two of its last nine, Ohio has made from the floor. And Tulsa on a 7-0 run over this last 123.
Just about 5 or 6 minutes ago, we were getting beat by 5 to 7 rebounds in the rebound war. We've battled all the way back to take the lead on that end of it. We're out rebounding them by one. It's going to be key here down the stretch to grab the big rebounds.
So here comes Ohio, trying to figure out a way to get momentum going back its way. With 3:12 to go in the game, it's 81-79 Tulsa, or Ohio, with Tulsa trailing by two, 81-79. Here come the Bobcats. It's Dardis across the timeline, guarded by Harrison. Left side it goes for Simmons. Simmons to the free throw line, stops, guarded there by Curtis. They kick out for Dardis. Shot clock at three. Dardis falls, slips, grabbed by Harrison to Woodard. Two on one. Woodard fouled by Simmons. And he'll go to the free throw line.
Well, another great defensive sequence right there. Hands, happy hands, I call them, active hands, making it difficult for Ohio.
Ohio with three turnovers in the last 153. And Tulsa has created baskets off of that. Three of its last three have gone down for the Hurricane. A 7-0 run over those 2 minutes. And Woodard makes the free throw. It rattled out and back in.
That's the roll we were not getting for three quarters of the game.
It's 81-80, Ohio leading Tulsa. Makes it. Second one. And we are tied for the first time since early in the game with no score.
It's unbelievable. Down 19 in the second half, have come all the way back.
Tulsa hasn't led this entire game. 81-81 with 2.5 to go. Dardis to Simmons. Now left side scramble. And it's Harrison who has it. Left side Curtis. Layup good. Markel Curtis on transition for Tulsa. And the Hurricane taking a 83-81 lead with 2:15 to go.
Once again, started by Shaq Harrison.
Simmons with it for Ohio. Left wing for Dardis. Can't find anything back to Simmons. Now Kaminsky. Bounce pass to Simmons at the top of the key. Guarded by Harrison. Simmons goes in on Harrison. No, lost the handle. And it'll go to Tulsa. Out of bounds it goes. It's Tulsa basketball with 1:56 to go and a 2-point lead.
Right here, you have to be extremely smart with the basketball. No empty possessions moving forward. We've got to get a good shot or two free throws.
Burt with a bounce pass to Harrison. Harrison will take his time with 20 seconds on the shot clock and 1:45 on the game clock. He dribbles low. He watches the situation. He comes off a screen from Swanigan. He goes left side for Burt. Three. Good by Pat Burt. Burt drilled the three from the left wing. And Tulsa leads by five with 1:25 to go. Simmons back the other way. Right side. Harley for three. Well short. Rebound. It goes out of bounds. Whose ball? Tulsa ball.
I'm almost speechless over here. I mean, Shaquille Harrison has such poise about him, and for Burt to step up and make a shot like that in a game like this is unbelievable.
What a turnaround. Tulsa up 86-81 with 1:17 to go. And the basketball. Ohio applying pressure. Curtis with the inbound pass to Harrison. Guarded by Dardis. Switches to his left hand, Harrison. Now dribbles to the top of the key. Dardis tried to steal it away, couldn't. Harrison will back it out and watch the clock tick. 102, 101, a minute to go. He dribbles around the logo, shot clock at 9, 8, 7. Harrison driving on Dardis, lost the handle, taken away. It's Seti with it for Ohio. He crosses the timeline. He gets it to Kaminsky. Kaminsky thought about a three, lost the handle. Now he tries to call a timeout, and he does. He is granted that timeout. And so Ohio with the basketball with 22 seconds on the shot clock. And 42.6 on the game clock, down by five. Let's pause 10 seconds for station identification. This is TU basketball from Learfield Sports.
Wow, that's all I can say.
What a ball. Second half, and with an incredible run, Ohio has turned it over five times in the last 4 minutes, a scoring drought of 4 minutes. Tulsa over those 4 minutes, a 14-0 run, 5 of 5 from the floor, and overtaking this game with 42.6 seconds left on the clock, 86-81.
Momentum is everything in basketball, and we have the seniors that were not going to be denied today. Now it's time to take care of the basketball. They're going to have to foul us. We're going to have to make free throws.
It's Ohio ball. underneath the basket, 86-81, the Tulsa lead. Simmons with 22 seconds on the shot clock. He looks for an open man, Kaminsky, has it. Guarded by Harrison, tipped it away. Now Seti had it stripped by Harrison, but a foul is called on Shaq. He was looking to go back the other way again. Harrison with 29 points and just committed his first foul of the game.
That's an amazing stat considering how hard he's played on defense tonight.
He has been all over the place. Seti, free throw is up and it is good. ...86-82 with 39.6 on the clock. Tulsa in the lead. Seti's next one is no good. Missed it short. Rebound scrambled for Swanigan. And it goes off the Ohio player Simmons. And it's going to be Tulsa basketball with 37.2 on the clock and an 86-82 lead.
Frank doing a great job again, subbing offense, defense right now. Gets another ball handler, Ray, into the game.
Officials now having a quick talk as Curtis is in the game with Woodard, Burt, Harrison, and Ray.
Looks like they're looking at the monitor just to make sure that was out on Ohio.
They are going to take a look. Possession arrow in favor of Tulsa. Tulsa with two timeouts remaining, Ohio with none. And Ohio has watched that shooting percentage drop. Just 33% in this second half, 6 of 18, as Tulsa clamped down defensively. Ohio 50% for the game. And Tulsa's shooting percentage has risen now to 46% for the game.
They've confirmed that it is Tulsa ball.
It'll be Tulsa basketball with 37.2 seconds on the clock. 86-82 lead for the Hurricane. What a tremendous second half effort. The Unwrap a Jaguar sales event is happening now. Visit JaguarTulsa.com for attractive lease and finance offers. Tulsa basketball sponsored by J.D. Young, the business solutions people.
Now we're seeing Ohio in full court press created some difficulty for us getting the ball in bounds. We had to call a timeout.
Tulsa calls a timeout with 37.2 seconds on the clock. Wow, I mean, what an unbelievable turn of events here in the second half. Tulsa coming off a dramatic win over Wichita State by 10 at the Reynolds Center, then had about a 9-hour turnaround, got on a plane early in the morning on Wednesday to get here, arrived here about 4:30, 5 o'clock local time. We're 2 hours ahead of Tulsa Central Time. The team settled in on Thursday, had a spirited practice, got their legs under them, then just came out cold today.
Burt just came over. He's got a big old smile on his face. I think he's ready to win this thing.
Harrison with the inbound pass. Gets it to Curtis. 5 seconds separate the game clock and shot clock. 30 seconds on the game clock, 23 on the shot clock. Curtis, and a foul is called as Harrison received the pass from Curtis. Simmons called for the foul, and Harrison goes to the free throw line. Up by 4, 86-82.
What a great set drawn up by Frank right there. I mean, the Hurricane just busted right through that full court press.
How much fun is this? Shaq. Left-handed shot on the way, and it is good. Beautiful spin, 30 points for Shaquille Harrison. Next one coming from Shaq. One bounce, one spin. It's on the way, and it is good.
Those two were pure.
88-82, it's a two-possession game. Ohio quickly up the floor. Simmons driving, puts up a layup, good. Jerron Simmons scores. That's 29 points for the Ohio point guard to make it 88-84. 22.3 seconds left. The pass, Harrison to Burt. Back to Harrison. Did he lose it? Yes, they'll call a double dribble on Shaq Harrison, a turnover. It'll be Ohio ball with 18.4 seconds on the clock.
Couldn't see it from here because his back was to us, but just a two-possession game. We got to tighten up.
Dardis with the inbound pass. He gets it to Simmons across the timeline, right side of the floor. Leaves it for Kaminsky. Three ball, no. Rebound, scramble. Kaminsky gets it. Now to Dardis, long three. It goes for Jordan Dardis. And it's a one-point game. Long pass to Woodard, and a foul is called on Harley as Woodard is fouled with 6 seconds left, 88-87.
Big-time shot there from about 25 feet right outside the Ohio bench.
My goodness. Dardis with 14 points. Woodard at the line. He has 13. Make it 14 with the free throw. It's 89-87 with 6 seconds to go. Woodard. One dribble. Free throw is up. It is good. It rattles in. James Woodard hits the free throw and makes it a three-point game. 90-87.
Right here, you got to extend your defense, make it difficult on them to get it past half court. Do not foul and don't give up an open three. They only have 6 seconds to do it, so if we put a little pressure on them, it's going to make it tough.
After the game, we'll hear the Don Thornton Cadillac post game. We'll hear from Coach Frank Haith. We'll certainly request Shaq Harrison to come over to the Don Thornton Cadillac broadcast booth and talk about this performance, and we'll keep our fingers crossed for a Tulsa win. Tulsa up by three with 6 seconds left. It'll be Ohio ball coming out of the timeout. Ohio led by 19 in the second half.
They have definitely cooled off. They were on fire for a large part of the game, but Tulsa's defense has gotten better, and it's making it difficult on them.
Frank Haith giving last-minute instructions to his team in the timeout. Ohio breaks its timeout. They're out on the floor with Simmons, Kaminsky, and certainly they'll try to get him the ball. He has 21 points, 5 of 9 from three-point range.
Here we are in our full court pressure.
Ohio needs a three to tie. 5 seconds left. Simmons with four. Simmons tried to find Kaminsky, and a foul is called on Harrison. Fouled Simmons with 2.1 seconds left. Did not allow Ohio to set up for a three. Simmons at the free throw line. He has 29. First one is up and good. It's 90-88, Tulsa on Ohio with 2.1 seconds left. They bring in Doug Taylor, bringing in some
rebounders,
big boys to try to grab a rebound.
I got to believe he's going to try to miss it here.
They have Campbell and Taylor, two of their biggest bodies in there, fighting with Wright and Swanigan. Simmons at the free throw line. He gets the ball. He throws it off the rim. It is grabbed by Harrison, and the buzzer sounds. And Tulsa wins the game 90-88 at the Paradise Jam in the Virgin Islands, roaring back from 19 down to claim victory in the first round.
They stole that one. I mean, that is unbelievable effort by a group of seniors that were not going to be denied in Paradise.
What a tremendous victory for Frank Haith and staff as Tulsa cold in the first half, Ohio red hot, but the Bobcats unable to stop the Hurricane this afternoon. Tulsa wins it 90-88, a jubilant Tulsa crowd behind the bench jumping and clapping.